Bonjour, Annie. This is Kathy Chavers. It's Thursday afternoon. I'd like to give you an update from Boysport. Right now, we still have two positive cases, and that's all. And all have been contact tracing done and quarantined or isolated. So please do not worry. Everything is fine right now. We only have the two cases that were diagnosed the other day. The other thing is that with the items coming up, such as at Fortune Bay or at the Government Center, there's going to be a new normal. And within the next few months, we'll be seeing some changes with regards to either events at the Government Center here or with regards to Fortune Bay. An example of that is our Veterans Day celebration that we have for our veterans in November for recognition of their service to our country. And we usually have a dinner and gifts and what have you, but this year we'll be just sending out gift cards and a thank you card and signed by the council because we just don't want any large gatherings. You'll also see this with Fortune Bay, where they will be having some what you might want to do variations to different events that they've had in the past. This year for Thanksgiving, they are going to be having a Thanksgiving to go. So please watch for that promotion where you can order your meal and come and pick it up. And I believe they will have the prices also on that, and just go on the Fortune Bay Facebook website. And so with that, we know that the state of the band will be done by video this year. We are trying to get some things together that we can do for our tribal members with the COVID funding. We have just had a meeting now today with regards to some of the monies that were unable to be spent, or some of the projects were funded by other projects, dollars, and so we went through and are looking at trying to expend those monies by December 30. So we are looking at ways to spend the money out once it's all completed. We will be giving a full financial status report, but our CFO told us today that at least almost 50% of the money we've received has gone out to our tribal members, either through various programs such as our Safe Shelter program and the Stay at Home and the COVID Relief Fund. So we're very proud of that because, you know, the government could have used the money for programs and services or things that we needed, but we felt that our band members also needed assistance at this time. And so there may be some new projects coming up. We have 70 days to spend the money. And so we will be looking at some other ways to get those dollars spent in various programs, such as right now we're looking at some iPads for the Netlick School because they're in need of those and they're out of date, the ones they have. So just various ways of trying to spend the money. We are going to be possibly heading up a food preservation program where people are sent either some items to work with to preserve food, and we've got a lot of ideas, but we'll let you know more about that as the events come up. So please look for those, and if you have questions, just call 218-757-3261. I'd also like to announce that our Boys and Girls Clubs are open this week from 8 to 4:30, today and tomorrow. Next week though, please look on the Boys and Girls Facebook page to see what that schedule will be, because we've heard that Northwood School is closed on Wednesdays now, and so the hours will be posted for next Wednesday for the clubs. Okay, we also have an issue with Bears and Vermilion. I've been asked by the Vermilion rep, Pete Boney, to please take care of your garbage, and that there is a pesky bear over there that is disrupting some of the residences there in Vermilion. So just a heads up that there is some bear activity over on the Vermilion side, and make sure your garbage is up and or take it to the garbage to the dump, and make sure it's taken care of. I was also asked by Travis Bakke, our career specialist, to announce that we do have the laptop program for our students in post-secondary or going to college. They are available to all band members throughout the country. And the contact for that is Leanne Hoffman, and you can reach her at 218-757-3261. And we do have some laptops actually going down to some students down in the Minneapolis area. So we want them to have access to these, and this was out of our CARES Act funding, excuse me. We're working on ways to try to better the communities and be safe at the same time. So like I said, we will be doing videos next Thursday, though I will be out of town, so I will have someone else do a video. We have our MCT meetings at Grand Portage, which are going to be done by Zoom for the membership. And so I will be having someone else do a video next Thursday. If anything happens with regards to any more active cases, we will get an update out to tribal members. And also November 1st, the Boys Fort News should be coming out. So we hope to have some more news in there or more tidbits of information that you can use during this terrible time. So with that, I'd like to say, Chi-Mig-Witch, stay safe, wear your mask, social distance. It sounds like a repetitive broken record, but health experts have said that it works, and I believe so. And please check on your neighbors, your friends, your family, your relatives, and your coworkers, because it is a tough time. It is getting cold. Winter's going to be coming, and we will be locked up inside because of the snow, so we aren't going to be out and about as much. So we want everybody to be healthy, both mentally, physically, and emotionally. So everybody take care of yourselves, and have a good day. Chi-Mig-Witch, thank you. Bye.